हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू अवर वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन कोर्स टाइटल फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स 2. दिस इज अवर 15th लेक्चर एंड इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल कंटिन्यू विद अवर प्रीवियस टॉपिक डेवलपमेंट ऑफ लिफ्ट एंड वी विल डिस्कस मैग्नस इफेक्ट एंड लोकेशन ऑफ स्टैग्नेशन पॉइंट. सो एज वी हैव डिस्कस इन द प्रीवियस केस, टोटल 3 केसेस. इन द फर्स्ट केस सिलेंडर वॉज स्टेशनरी एंड फ्लूइड वॉज मूविंग विद यूनिफॉर्म वेलोसिटी यू. इन द सेकेंड केस cylinder was subjected to constant circulation and fluid was stationary. And in the third case, which was the combination of first two cases, cylinder is subjected to constant circulation and which is placed in flowing fluid, which is moving with the uniform velocity u. And in that case, we have got the equation for the velocity on the surface of cylinder as 2u sine of theta plus gamma upon 2 pi r, where this theta is going to govern whether this 2u sine of theta component will be get added with this gamma upon 2 pi r. So for the lower portion, theta would be sine theta would be the negative, and in that case this component would be the subtracted. So velocity of the all those locations which are located below to the horizontal axis of this cylinder would be the lesser as compared to the top velocity, and due to that there will be a pressure difference, because in the lower portion flow is getting deaccelerated and in the upper portion flow is getting accelerated. So there will be a decrease in pressure in the upper side and there will be an increase in pressure from in the downward side according to Bernoulli's, and due to that pressure difference there is net vertical force which is going to act on this cylinder, that is lift force. So by providing constant circulation to the cylinder in the flowing field, we can generate a lift on the cylinder, and that's what the Magnus effect, that's why we call it as a Magnus effect. So when any cylinder which is subjected to constant circulation and placed in flowing fluid, so in that case there would be a net vertical force which is acting on the cylinder, and this phenomenon of the generation of the net vertical force, that is lift force getting generated on the cylinder, rotating cylinder in the uniform flow field, is known as Magnus effect. The this effect has been given as name of that particular person who has investigated this phenomenon in 1852, a German scientist, H.G. Magnus, and he has found that if constant circulation is given to the cylinder, and if that cylinder is placed in flowing fluid with the uniform velocity, which is moving with the uniform velocity, in that case there would be net vertical force acting on the cylinder, that is lift force. Even this particular phenomenon also applicable in the table tennis, golf or cricket. In case of table tennis, if you see when they are using a smash, at that time they are just making that a shot by using that bat as in curved direction. So due to that that particular small ball, whatever that we are referring it as, pinch ball, getting rotated, and due to that rotation it will be subjected to certain flight, that is it will be subjected to the lift force, because it is rotating and moving through the air. At that time at the upper portion flow will be get accelerated, and at the lower portion flow will be get deaccelerated, and due to that pressure difference it will be subjected to net vertical or net lift force, which may act upward or downward. Again, in case of golf ball, whenever that golf balls has been hit by someone, at that time when it is flowing through the air, at that time it will be rotating, and due to that rotation it will be subjected to lift. Again, in the cricket ball as well, when the you might have heard that word by from the commentator commentators when they are referring it as a flighted delivery. So whenever they want to give a flight to the ball, at that time they will just rotate that ball, try to swing it in the air, and due to that swinging effect there would be a vertical lift force would be generated that there, and due to that vertical lift what we are calling it as that ball will be subjected to slightly a flight in the vertical direction. That's why those deliveries are generally known as flighted delivery. Again, if we see here in case of lift, when the lift is getting developed on the cylinder, at that time if you talk about see about the vertical axis, so the flow pattern about this vertical axis is symmetrical on both the side. So whatever the net drag force which is acting on the cylinder would be the zero, because whatever the pressure on the right side and left side, that is on the upstream face and downstream face, would be the same and opposite in the direction. So net drag force which is acting on the cylinder is zero. But if you see here, the symmetry of the flow pattern about the horizontal axis, it is different, and due to that difference in flow pattern, there would be a vertical lift force which is acting on this particular cylinder. Now we will see the stagnation point, how to locate those stagnation point. By using this equation, we can locate the stagnation point. As we know, velocity at any point on the surface of the rotating cylinder is given by 2u sine of theta plus gamma upon 2 pi r. So by putting the value of u is equal to 0, because we are computing stagnation point. Stagnation point are those point where velocity is 0. So by putting u is equal to 0, you will get the equation 2u sine of theta plus gamma upon 2 pi r. So for the sine of theta, I can say that it will be given by equal to minus gamma upon 4 pi r. And by using this equation, we can compute the location of stagnation points on the cylinder. So by looking to this equation, we can say that sine theta is negative. That means that all the stagnation point, if you are going to locate it, those will be located below to the horizontal axis of the cylinder, because sine theta is 0 in between 180 to 360. So our separation points or stagnation point would be located in the lower portion only, and again it will lies in between 180 to 360. So we are going to define those stagnation point. Let us consider the first case, where just put the circulation is equal to 0. So if there is no circulation to the cylinder, in that case sine theta would be the 0, and in that case theta will be equal to sine theta will be 0 at the 0 degree and at the 180. So sine value of sine theta is 0 when theta is 0 and theta is equal to 180 degree. So in that case, we are getting the location of stagnation point. Here it is stagnation point 1 at the 0 degree and stagnation point 2 at the 180 degree. And this is what our case of the ideal fluid. So this is our first case where there was no rotation to the cylinder, no rotation was given to the cylinder. So we are getting that same case here by putting the value of rotation as 0. Again, for the second case, if the value of gamma is less than 4 pi r, so in that case, if the value of this gamma is less than 4 pi r, in that case whatever this total ratio will become less than minus 1. So in that case, so value of the sine theta will be less than minus 1. Now the value of sine theta will be less than minus 1 in only case when my value of sine theta is when the theta is going to vary in between 180 degree to the 360 degree. So if I am measuring from this reference point, so in this direction I will get two points. One will be located in the in this portion, that is in minus 90 degree. If you measure from this side, it will be 270 plus degree, and it will another stagnation point which will be located at the more than 180 degree. So there are two stagnation point for this case when rotation is less than 4 pi ur. In that case, sine theta would be the less than minus 1, and in that case location of stagnation points will be in between 180 degree to 90 degree. So more strictly or more precisely, theta will be less than minus 90 and greater than 180 degree. Now in the next case, if my circulation is equal to 4 pi r, in that case value of the sine theta will be minus 1, because equation of the sine theta is given by minus gamma upon 4 pi r. So if the value of this ratio is 1, in that case sine theta would be minus 1, and value of the sine theta is minus 1 at the point of when theta is equal to 270 degree. So I can say that when my theta is minus 90 degree or theta is plus 270 degree, at that time I will get that stagnation point in the case when my circulation is equal to 4 pi ur. So value of the constant circulation is equal to 4 pi ur. In that case, point of stagnation would be located at the 270 degree. Now the last case where sigma is greater than 4 pi ur, If it is greater than 4 pi UR, that means that value of sine theta would be greater than minus 1, which is not possible, because in that case the point of stagnation would be located beyond the surface of the cylinder. So this case not possible. So the value of the constant circulation cannot be possible beyond the value of 4 pi UR, because in that case point of stagnation would be located at beyond the surface of the cylinder. So only three cases are possible for the location of point of stagnation. The first, stagnation point is located at 0 degree and 180 degree. In the second case, point of stagnation is located in between minus 0 to minus 90 degree and 180 to 270 degree, two stagnation point. In the third case, there will be only one stagnation point exist, that would be located on theta is equal to 270 degree. And in the fourth case, which is not possible, where point of stagnation would be located beyond the surface of cylinder, which is not possible. So that's it in this lecture. Thank you for watching.